Hi everyone, this is Tuplex. Welcome back. As you can see, I've been doing some work on the base since we left. I've got now one line of each of the key commodities, including stone, and I have some stone brick producing as well. I put the priority on the splitter on the stone output. I don't think we're going to need a lot of stone brick right now. I did use some of it to upgrade this iron line to steel furnaces, and I put in some red belts, in order to get a full red belt of iron, and that feeds over here. Now down here I built red and green science. You've all seen that many times, I'm sure. This build is pretty similar to what I just did in the tutorial, except that I doubled it. So I've got 10 machines making red science, 12 making green science, which gives us about 90 per minute, more or less. At least it should. Oh, you know what? It's not, because I need more labs. Let's add a few more labs. Be six. I'll add nine more, let's say. So we'll take. No, actually, I want. Why do I have so many? Why do I have so many power poles? Okay, I guess I have to have so many power poles. But here I don't. Oh, okay, that's because this one covers that. I got it now. Okay. Well, anyway. Just to keep things nice and consistent. Let's do that. All right, and then if I'm going to add three more rows, two, three, I need to do that. And that. Okay. So I'm just doing all the red and green science right now, obviously. I turned auto research on, and then I filtered it so that it's only allowed to research stuff that uses red and green. If you don't do that, it'll sometimes put something in the queue that requires a science pack that you don't have yet, and then it'll just sit there not doing anything. So that's why I did that, to make sure it didn't pick something that used green or military science. Okay, so I've got most of the basic research done that I've been doing as I've been working. I got the rail stuff researched, including TSM. Okay, so I can now make the TSM supplier and requester stops and all that good stuff. So we can get started with rail. What else? I've got oil researched, so we could start with oil. I put in a second power line down here just because I wanted it to be there when I needed it, and I had a bunch of iron and gears and stuff on me, so I just went ahead and built it. and then I made this little thing here, so when I get a bunch of extra wood, I put it here in this chest, and it gets run down to be consumed by the power. Over here, one full line of copper. I've got stone, I've got coal, I've got two, almost three full lines of iron ore. Not quite three, since this one is not 15 per side, but pretty close. And this is the one that's feeding the iron over here. And then I've got this red splitter with priority on the iron side so that we can make sure this belt stays full. And then everything else will go up here to the steel. Let's see, what else? Okay, and then over here, I'm just starting to build a little mall. Now, I'm also going to want to do a little bit of blue science. Let's figure out how much blue science I want to do before I shut things down here in the main base, or in the starter base, I should say. Now, I was thinking that I would like to get bots going. But I just wonder how far I really need to go with it. I don't want to do too much in the starter base, because like I said before, I want to play this game where we expand early. So I don't want to do too much in the starter base, just enough to kind of get things going. It would be nice to have another personal roboport and ditch this energy shield so I can run more bots. I could run another 10 construction bots. What would I need to do that? I would need to at least get personal roboports researched to make another one. So that would require all this stuff. Construction bots. So maybe I'll just do that. I'll go up to personal roboport. That would include modular armor. And I'll also research logistics bots. And then I think I'll stop there. That way I can use logistics bots in the mall to refill my inventory. But again, I'm not going to be using bots for anything else, except for what I do here in the starter base, you know, except for like a mall to refill my own supplies. I'm not going to use bots, for constructing anything in the base. Okay. So like I said, I'm starting to build a little mall over here. I've been accumulating belts here, but I think I should stop that because I need to produce belts over in the mall so that I can use those to make inserters or underground belts and splitters. So I'm gonna stop the queuing of this. Okay, and then I want those to go on the far side of that belt so I can just put a longhand inserter there. Okay, and I'm not buffering any inserters down here either. Okay, let's get rid of some junk. I actually never used that burner mining drill. I feel pretty proud of myself. Let's get rid of the pistol. And let's make ourselves a machine gun. And then I'll just get rid of this. I already crafted myself some turrets. Although I haven't used them yet, I haven't killed any biters yet, but I will. We can see already some of them are starting to appear in the map. So those are the ones that we'll have to go in and destroy sooner or later. There. Okay, so that stuff's gone. I have a gazillion power poles here that I made with extra wood that I had in my inventory. Okay, and so like I said, I got started with them all here. So what I did is, this is really similar to what I've seen Nephrums and Anti-Elites do in their speed runs, you know, where I just get a combined belt of gears and green circuits, run it next to a belt of iron, and with those things you can make, you know, you can make almost anything in the game practically. For the circuits, what I did is I made assembly machine twos, and then those feed into assembly machine ones. And this works perfectly because, as you know, normally, if we were using all of the same machine type, you would need three copper wire machines feeding into two green circuit machines to keep them running. But in this case, the assembly machine ones are actually slower. They have a speed of 0.5 versus a crafting speed of 0.75 on the assembly machine twos. So when you do that, one assembly machine two can make the copper cables fast enough to keep the assembly machine one running nonstop. So that's why I just have a 1-to-1 ratio here. And I kind of like the nice clean layout that that produces. And then I'm making some gears over here. These gears are for my own personal use. So I can just come over and grab a stack or two of gears when I need some. I'm making some grenades over here. Okay, so I'm just grabbing coal off of the end of this line. I've got that limited to 2 stacks. And that's just for clearing trees mainly. All right, so down here I got started already with inserters. So I've got yellow, blue, and red, and lots of them. So yeah, let's do some logistics parts. The yellow ones, at least. So we'll do the regular belts in the middle, and then those will feed to both sides. Okay, let's make this kind of symmetrical. Okay, and then on one side we can do undergrounds, and on the other side we can do splitters. So I'll set those to 2 stacks each, and I'll set the belts to 4. Okay, and I'm going to get them started because I have a lot of extra belts, actually. All right, so this one needs iron plate, and this one needs iron plate and circuits. Okay, so that's why I needed a red belt for iron, because one yellow belt wouldn't be quite enough to keep all this running. And pretty soon, actually, I'm not going to be doing any more research. So once we get that research done that we just discussed, then I'll probably just shut down all the science production here in the starter base, and from that point forward, I'll just use it as a mall. Okay, yeah, and you can see it's even with that, I'm using up a lot of iron. Okay, well, let's start. Let me craft a few more assemblers, and let's start making rail components. Okay, so I'm gonna make. Well, first let's look at ingredients. I want to start making rails. Those take stone, steel, and iron sticks. Okay, so I've got steel up here, so I need to get steel down there. Yeah, and I'm afraid until these fill up, it looks like I'm gonna be running out of iron. Even with this red belt. Okay, now it might help if I add some more red here. I was being pretty economical with the red belts since they're so expensive this early in the game. Okay, and then I've got priority on these splitters going out to the science. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and grab these because I do need some. But I won't be too greedy yet. All right, so let's continue that belt. All right. How do I want to do this? This makes 2 per cycle, so that's pretty fast. So I think with one we'll be okay. Okay. So that's rail, and then let's get our belt of steel and bring that down here. Now, once I have mining and smelting outposts built, then I'll, well, like I said, I'll probably continue to use this as a dedicated mall, but eventually we'll need a grid section that's got trains coming in carrying, you know, iron, steel, copper, or green circuits, and so on, bringing everything that we need. Okay, so that's going to be the iron stick, and this will be the rail. Okay, actually, you know what, let's, why don't we just convert to yellow belt at this point, because I'm using up most of the iron anyway. Okay, so that'll go like that. Actually, let's keep with our theme here. This needs the iron stick, it needs the steel, so I'm going to have to put the steel inserter right there so it can reach all the way to that third belt, and it can actually jump across the power pole. Okay, and then I need the stone. So why don't I do this? Okay, and then I'll bring the stone right there. Wait a minute. Yeah, that's right. Actually, let's do this. Okay. And then I'll put a chest there. Bam. Okay. And I am just going to let that fill up. And then we need rail signals, of course. We're going to need a lot of those. And those just take plates and circuits. So I'll put those side by side here. Regular signals, chain signals. Oh, and you know what? These stations require iron sticks too. All right, well, we'll do that. We'll do that next. All right. Yeah, let me get some more wood. I was going to say maybe I should start using iron chests instead, but I guess the wood chests are just as good. And I'm certainly not going to have any shortage of wood clearing these starting areas out, so. Okay. So this is going to take one of those. And one of those. All right, and I'll limit this to, I don't know, what, 4 stacks? Well, this is loading iron plate awfully slow, isn't it? Okay, so let's do something different. Let's put, if I put a large pole right there. Yeah, there we go. Okay. We doing here? Awesome. All right. Yeah, and then let's do, well, I'm going to have 3 types of train stops. So I'm going to need to put those all in a row. And the one in the middle will be the normal one. The regular one, and that needs iron sticks also. There we go. Okay, so there's the sticks. And then I'm going to need iron. I'm going to need steel. And I'm going to need circuits. And I can probably stop the iron sticks right there, right? Right. Yeah, so there's a supplier. And there's the requester. There. All right, and we'll throw in a couple of lights. Okay, and I'm going to limit these to one stack each. All right, let's get rid of some trees. I still have a long way. I still have a lot of room before I get to the other side. But, you know, I don't want to... I'm not going to go crazy here. I just want to build some of the... some of the basics. Now this this rail design does not include any lights. Okay, so I don't need to mass produce lights. At some point, well, I don't know. At some point I might put in a mod that gives us 100% daylight. But I'm not sure if I want to do that or not. I'm also not sure if I want to power the base with solar or nuclear yet. So I think we'll just wait a while and see how that works out before we make a decision on that. Okay, now let's make locomotives and wagons. All right, and for that I'm going to need engines. And I also need pipes anyway. So we can make that stuff up here. Yeah, so for sure I need something making pipes. I'll make lots of pipes. And then some of those pipes we can run across this way and we can use that. Actually, let's do this instead. I think this is more elegant. I'm not going to make underground pipes because I can always just make those myself. You know, if you have a lot of regular pipes and you have a couple stacks of iron plates, you can make a lot of the regular pipes on your own. You know what? Actually, I should put that on a belt because I should have... let's have at least two machines making engines right now just because they're so slow to craft. And then I'll put the output right here on the same belt. Okay, and then those are going to need plates. And, or no, they need steel and gears. Okay, so there's steel. And then there are the gears. foot was in the way. Oh. Duh. All right. Okay. Now we got some engines. Okay. So with that, we can make locomotives. Actually, that probably only needs to go there. I'll go ahead and load that up. And we're going to need lots of those, so I'll do, I don't know, 4 stacks, and we'll just let it start crafting. All right, so we need steel, and we need circuits. Okay, and that'll take a while because we need 20 engines for each of those. I should make more engines. This is gonna be too slow otherwise. Okay, so I need to make a dedicated engine line, I think. I've got a bunch of gears here. Let me turn this one off. Let's make this pipes. Yeah, and I got steel up there. Yeah, sweet. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Well, seven. Eight. That's a nice round number. Few lights. That was not the best place for lights, actually. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to put the lights there. I'll put the lights somewhere else. Okay, yeah, I'll just put some lights down here. Okay. So Now we've got engines. All right. Need to craft more of those assembly machines. I wouldn't mind having more gears and green circuits and iron plates. Okay, so now we'll make the train engines, or the locomotives, as they're called. What else do we need? Green circuits. You would need green circuits. Okay. We'll make four stacks. And this will be train cars, cargo wagons, and those I'll make eight stacks. Because I'm going to have twice as many cargo wagons as I do locomotives. Plates, steel, and gears. Yeah. Oh, man, that's too bad. Nope. There we go. Plates, gears. There we go. Okay, so I've got five. I need four to make our first train, and I'll need eight of those. Those I can probably handcraft some. Yes, I can. How many have I got? Three plus five. Okay. All right, now let's grab some rail. Let's grab a stack of signals, and we can start putting together the first of the grid sections. Oh, I need those big power poles. Those take iron sticks too. Man, these iron sticks are a lot more ubiquitous than I thought they would be. Okay. What if I do that? Oh, no, I can't do it there. If I do it there. Okay, and this will be big poles. All right. Let me relocate this a little bit. We go four and then reverse it. Right there. Okay, that's not gonna work. There we go. Big poles, little poles, and those both need steel. I don't really have a convenient path to get it to come down this way, do I? Okay, let's do this. There. All right. Big poles, little poles. They need steel, which they can get that way. And let me get some more undergrounds. I think this is probably the craziest mall I've ever built. Oh, my inventory's full. Okay, let's get rid of some of this stone. I want to get rid of more of this stone. I'll dump it over here into the brick ovens. Okay. And then I will also start collecting some of it. Ooh, looks like I'm almost out of research. How are we doing on power? We're doing fine. Okay. And now I can get rid of this underground that I ended up never using, and we'll put the stone in there. Okay, great. And then we can pick up all these iron sticks. All right, iron stick, copper, copper. There we go. And then we just need a place to put them. Go. So let's do, I don't know, two stacks of each. And then we can throw in a light. Not bad. This is not bad for a couple hours work, I don't think. Again, it's not super neat or pretty, but it's kind of temporary, so. All right, let's grab some of those. We're going to need 8 per side for each grid. Or 8 for one side and 7 for the other 3. Or 8 for two sides and 6 for the other 2. So that's what, 16, 22, 28. Of course, I could have just looked at this and it would tell me 40. Where do you get 40? That's not right. That must be for the whole blueprint book. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 16. Oh, okay. Yeah, I did some counting wrong. I don't know. That doesn't seem right. All right. Let's start laying down some rail. And then we can put in our first train. Okay, so as I mentioned before, these trains are going to be 4-8 trains, big trains, which means we're going to be carrying big loads. Deliveries will be bigger but less frequent. And because of that, we should avoid a lot of traffic issues. I don't think that one went down properly. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Whoops. 7, 8. Okay. Yeah, so it looks like we're done. We're done with all the purely red and green research that we can do. Okay, so at this point, I'm going to disable auto research. And I will manually queue up the technology that I wanted to do, which, and that was to get up to personal RoboPort, right? So we'll do advanced oil, we'll do lubricant, electric engines, robotics, construction robotics, personal RoboPort, and then I also said we would do logistics robots. We'll do logistics robots, and then after that I'll do whatever robot upgrades we can do with blue science packs, and then that'll be it. Okay, let's go in the other direction so I can ride in the train. Okay, so some of you might be wondering why we have so many train engines. And that is simply to have better acceleration. And I've messed around with trains of this size in a creative mode game. And when you put uranium fuel in those things, let me see. Uranium fuel. Where do you get the uranium fuel from? There we go. You get it from Kovrex enrichment. Nuclear fuel, that's what it's called. Vehicle acceleration 250% of what it would be with, I don't know, with coal or wood. I mean, you can see even now. I mean, look how fast, especially if you've been watching the trains in my tutorial series, which are one engine and four wagons. Look how fast this thing accelerates. So essentially what we want is one locomotive for every two wagons. One locomotive has the same weight as two wagons. And at some point, somebody calculated that you had a good ratio between acceleration, top speed, and the size of your train if you used two wagons for every one locomotive. So that's what I'm going to do. And I'm going to come here and turn right. Right, this is awesome. Second episode and we're already making trains. I think I'm going to have to go back and get more signals pretty soon. So obviously with my very slow starter bots, this is going to take a while. Although we'll get a speed upgrade, we'll get a cargo upgrade, that'll help. Maybe I should do nanobots. I might do nanobots. Cause those will definitely be faster than real bots at this stage of the game. radar coverage is like in comparison with the size. It looks like, geez, I don't know. I'm not sure if one radar can, I'm not sure if one radar can cover an entire grid section. I've got a mod called Big Brother that I use sometimes that gives you some research that you can run to increase the range of your radar. So if it turns out that a vanilla radar is not big enough to cover an entire grid section, then I'll get Big Brother so that we can upgrade the radar. Because I don't want to have to have, you know, I don't want to have more than one radar in each grid section just to be able to see it from the map. I think one each is about as far as I would want to have to go with it. Okay. Yeah, let me go grab some more supplies. And then we'll get this grid section finished. Now, the good thing about this is I'm building from about the middle down. So that means that, let me grab all those, and I'll grab half of the chain signals because I don't think this blueprint requires nearly as many chain signals. Well, yeah, about 75, 120 to 80. That's what, 3 to 2. Oh, let's get more of those power poles as well. There we go. Why did I only get 50? Oh, okay. Yeah, it's because my inventory's full. I can craft a few underground pipes. That'll clear out some slots. If you pick up a bunch of stone, you can make landfill with it. Oh, and I'm going to take this wooden chest, and in there I'm going to deposit all those stone furnaces that I made. I probably shouldn't have made quite so many, because I'm really not going to be using any more for the rest of the game, unless I decide to stay on steam power for a bit longer. It'll be nice when we get a full, when we get at least one full grid section done, because then we can drive around in circles and see how fast the train goes when it has four engines on it. It'll be fun. Now, I was saying that because I built from the top down, I have this whole, almost the entire top section of this grid where I can put in train stations later to deliver parts. I think there's a tree in my way here. Oh, there we go. Okay, well, I don't think you all need to wait around for this. This is going to take a while, and this is probably what I'll be doing for the next hour or so, just getting the two grid sections that I've got plopped down completed. So I'll continue to let this happen. I won't say that I'm going to work on it, because I really don't need to do anything except just stand here and push a button every once in a while. So I'll let this continue to happen. And I think maybe I'll do nanobots. Of course, if you do nanobots, you don't really need Tiny Start, do you? You don't need them both. Well, let's see how the bots are once I get a third personal RoboPort, right? I'll get rid of this energy shield. Well, how much power does this make? 150. Ugh. I'll try making another RoboPort and replacing the energy shield with it. And then with one or two upgrades to the bot speed and cargo size, then maybe it'll be more tolerable. So we'll just wait until we've got, until we've done all that. And then if the bots are still too slow, then maybe I'll just switch over to nanobots instead and use those until we can unlock, you know, the higher tier of armor and the fusion reactor. Now, I wonder if I can, it would be cool if you could make more of those tiny fusion reactors, but I don't think you can. I don't think it allows you to do that. No. Nope. You just get the one that you start the game with, and that's it. I think it would be cool if you could craft some of those, and then that way you can have better armor earlier. Because I really dislike having to use solar power in the early game on the power armor. It's just so weak. The lights in this train are pretty weak too, speaking of that. Huh. Okay, so when I move, it looks like my light mod kicks in when I'm moving, and then when I stop, it doesn't work anymore. Let's see if there's a setting for that. Per player, maybe. Shield or more solar? Extra battery? Yeah, okay. What's that mod called? Afraid of the dark. Yeah, it doesn't have any options. Now, another mod I could do, one that I've used before, we got a base here. I'm going to have to kill these guys. I don't want to run over them with a train. They'll come after me. I better do that before I continue this, because I don't have any ammo. I need to make some ammo first. So I'll go do that. Anyway, I have another mod, Inbuilt Lighting, I think it's called, where all of your power poles generate some light. So maybe I'll use that. And that'll help light up the whole base, since I'm going to have these power poles, and it'll help make up for the fact that there's no lighting on the power poles. I know that when, like I said, Alexei made his base in creative mode, and I think he had it set to be always daytime, which probably explains why he didn't feel any need to put lights in his rail blueprints. Well, and some people don't. I mean, I don't have lights in my rail blueprints either, but it would be nice to have some more light, especially since I'm recording. So I will put in, I'll install that mod for the next time. And I'm going to start making some ammo. I can make copper ammo, which is great. So I'll start doing that over here. I'll get these rails finished up, and then I will see you the next time. Thanks a lot for watching, everybody. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.